will we do with the drunken sailor? What will we do with the drunken sailor? What will we do with the drunken sailor early in the morning? Way hey, and up she rises. Way hey, and up she rises. Way hey, and up she rises early in the morning.
Shave his belly with a rusty razor. Shave his belly with a rusty razor. Shave his belly with a rusty razor early in the morning.
Way hey, and up she rises. Way hey, and up she rises. Way hey, and up she rises early in the morning.
We'll put him in a longboat till he's sober. Put him in a longboat till he's sober. Put him in a longboat till he's sober early in the morning.
Way hey, and up she rises. Way hey, and up she rises. Way hey, and up she rises early in the morning.
Not in the thick of the fight, not in the press of the odds, do the heroes come to their height, for we know the demigods. That stands over till peace. We can only perceive men returned from the seas, very grateful for leave. They grant us sudden days snatched from their business of war. But we are too close to appraise what manner of men they are. And whether their names go down with age-kept victories, or whether they battle and drown unreckoned, is hid from our eyes. They are too near. But our children shall understand when and how our fate has changed, and by whose hand. Our children shall measure their worth. We are content to be blood. But we know that we walk on a new world with the saviors.
Nur durch starke Berührung mit der See können wir den für uns möglichen weltumspannenden geistigen Horizont gewinnen. Ich meine nicht den Himmel oder im Abstrakten, sondern den in Erdenmenschen auch notwendigen, auch hier auf der Erde. Unsere wirtschaftliche Entwicklung ging in den letzten Jahrzehnten unterstützt von deutschen Preisen, deutscher Wissenschaft, mit Riesenschritten vorwärts. Darin lag der Stein des Anstoßes für England. Es war umso stärker, je mehr seine Fremdmagnaten die ganze Welt als die Krone betrachteten, die auszupressen, die das alleinige Monopol hält. Doch ehe wir eine in Betracht kommende Seemacht hatten, noch ehe ein Pottengest da war, das ist festzuhalten, hat eine politische Gruppe in England zusammen, die auf ihre Fahne schrieb, Germaniam esse den Ländern. Die von uns erklärte Seesperre durch die U-Boote, keine Vergeltungsmaßregeln, obwohl wir sie bei dem brutalen Zerreißen alles Seerechts durch England wohl als solche bezeichnen können. Unsere Seesperre ist vielmehr unser legales Recht. England sieht aber aus einer gewissen puritanischen Gedankenrichtung heraus alles als Unrecht und sogar als Frevel an, was ihm als außerwähltes Volk ungünstig ist. Alles als Recht, was ihm günstig. Auch hat seine politische Leitung es meisterhaft verstanden, den Völkern etwas von dieser Auffassung durch geschickte Propaganda vorerforderlich durch die Faust einzuflößen. Die rücksichtslose, die ratenhafte Behandlung der neutralen Schifffahrt ist nicht. Die Knebelung Portugals, die brutale Niederwerfung Griechenlands bringt nur den Frieden für die Wolke. Das ist ganz in der Ordnung. Als wir aber den Durchmarsch der Franzosen und Engländer durch Belgien vorkam, kannte man es als Verbrechen, das nur Barbaren und Kunden ausüben können. Doch kurz vor seinem Tode hat der Generaloberst von Wolfsburg gesagt, dass er vollständig orientiert gewesen sei für die Stellungnahme Belgiens beim Ausbruch eines etwaigen Weltkrieges. Der vor dem Krieg gerät französischer Amtsminister in Belgien steht bei offiziellen Gelegenheiten. Und sonst den Vorgänge dort. Ich erinnere nur an.
Slipped the surly bonds of earth and danced the skies on laughter-silvered wings. Sunward I've climbed and joined the tumbling mirth of sun-split clouds and done 100 things you have not dreamed of. Wheeled and soared and swung high in the sunlit silence. Hovering there, I chased the shouting wind along and flung my eager craft through footless halls of air. Up Up the long, delirious, burning blue, I topped the windswept heights with easy grace, whenever lark or even eagle flew. A while with silent, lifting mind, I trod the high, untrespassed sanctity of space. Put out my hand and touch the face of God. Oh, I have slipped the surly bonds of earth and danced the sky with laughter-silvered wings. Sunward I've climbed and joined the tumbling mirth of sun-split clouds and done 100 things you have not dreamed of, wheeled and soared and swung high in the sunlit silence. Hovering there, I've chased the shouting wind along and flung my eager craft through footless halls of air. The long, delirious, burning blue. I've topped the windswept heights with easy grace, whenever lark or even eagle flew. And while with silent, lifting mind I trod the high, untrespassed sanctity of space, put out my hand and touched the face of God.
When you see millions of the mouthless dead across your dreams in pale battalions blue, say not soft things as other men have said, that you'll remember, for you need not so. Give them not praise, or death, how should they know it is not curses heaped on each gashed head? Nor tears, their blind eyes see not your tears flow. Nor honor, it is easy to be dead. Say only this, they are dead. Then add thereto, yet many a better one has died before. Then, scanning all your crowded mass, should you perceive one face that you loved here to see?
Alas, he did worst.
It is a spook.
The mother said.
None wears the face.
You folded up the letter that she read.
Great death has made all his.
The crown worked so nicely. Something broke in the tired voice that quavered to the choke. She half looked up. We mothers are so proud of our dead soldiers. Then her face was bound. Quietly the brother officer went out. He'd told the poor old dear some gallant lies, that she would nourish all her days, no doubt. For a while he coughed and mumbled. Her weak eyes had shone with gentle triumph, brimmed with joy, because he'd been so brave, her glorious boy. He thought how Jack, cold-footed, useless, had panicked down the trench that night the mine went up at Wicked Corner. How he'd tried to get sent home, and how, at last, he died, blown to small bits. And no one seemed to care, except that lovely woman with white hair.
In Flanders field, poppies glow between the crosses, row upon row. That mark our place, and in the sky the lark still bravely sing and fly, scarce heard amid the guns below. We are the dead. Short days ago we lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved, and were loved. And now we lie in Flanders fields. Take up our quarrel with the foe. To you from failing hands we throw the torch. Be yours to hold it high. If ye break faith with us who die, we shall not sleep. Though poppies grow. Flanders.
Moving up and down again. There's no discharge in a war. 7, 6, 11, 5, 9 and 20 miles a day. 4, 11, 17, 32 the day before. Moving up and down again. There's no discharge in a war. Don't look at what's in front of you. Moving up and down again. Men go mad with watching them. There's no discharge in the war. Count the bullets in the bandoliers. If your eyes drop, they will get a problem. Moving up and down again. There's no discharge in the war. We can kick out hunger, thirst, and weariness. But not the chronic tiger stuff. Moving up and down again. There's no discharge in the war. Ain't told, stand, fine, stay because of company. But night, ring, long, sing the 40,000 million boots. Moving up and down again. There's no discharge in the war. I have marked it. We can tell and testify it is not fire, devil, dark, or anything but moving up and down again. There's no discharge in the war. Cry, but think of something different. Oh, my God, keep me from going lunatic. Moving up and down again.